By applying the 8 wastes of lean manufacturing to the context of software development, we should be able to deliver more customer value faster and cheaper. Let's go through them one by one, but first, what is lean? Lean manufacturing is a production system originally created to streamline the production of cars, physical cars, automobiles, in Toyota factories. This system has been tremendously successful and has not only forever changed manufacturing practices in many industries, but has also inspired adaptations like lean software development and the widely recognized concept lean startup, which you've probably heard before. Check out the link in the description to Eric Ries's seminal book, Lean Startup. An excellent starting point if you're looking to start your own business. A key concept in lean manufacturing is that of the 8 wastes, or muda in Japanese. I have no idea how to pronounce that, I'm sorry. The purpose of these 8 wastes is to help us identify non-value-adding activities so that we can eliminate them and thereby streamline the process and hence focus more on the activities that actually bring value. So we're trying to eliminate waste. Let's get into it. Number 1, overproduction. In manufacturing, this refers to the problem of producing more stuff than we are able to sell. This, of course, leads to unnecessary wear on machines, people, finished and unfinished goods, as well as increased storage costs. You need a bigger warehouse to store all the stuff that you've produced. So in short, we should try to produce as much as the customer wants, as quickly as they want it, but no more and no less. In software, overproduction can be interpreted as writing code for features that we don't know that the customer wants yet. Not only are we spending valuable man hours producing possibly unnecessary features, but we are also increasing the complexity of our software by introducing more code, which makes it more difficult to maintain, more difficult to change. So it's a double whammy. For many projects, the solution is usually to work iteratively. We plan and develop features only based on very recent customer feedback. Number 2, overprocessing. This means doing more than necessary, in the sense that the additional value that we've added can't be justified given the cost of producing it. In software, this usually means over-architecting. Choosing too complicated designs, frameworks, technologies, libraries, way before we have any evidence suggesting that we actually need it or that the customers even care. Many of us, myself included, just like to think about abstraction way too much. But this is an age-old problem in software, so we should just follow the old wisdom. Keep it simple, KISS, you ain't gonna need it, YAGNI, and avoid premature abstraction. We know what to do, so let's just resist the urge. Focus on building simple solutions and shipping valuable software to the customers today. Customers fundamentally don't care about how beautiful our abstractions are, and it doesn't matter how scalable our solutions are if we run out of money and get put out of business next week because we failed to attract customers by focusing too much on the code and not enough on what is actually valuable for the customers. Number 3, defects. Defects cause delays, reduce customer satisfaction, and can in some cases be outright dangerous. In software, this usually means bugs in the code. And usually the muda of defects is thought of as the problem of building the thing right rather than building the right thing. So it's about verification, it's not about validation. In other words, this is not a question of delivering the wrong thing, it's a question of delivering a broken thing. Bugs have been around since the dawn of software, and luckily there's a plethora of ways to address them. Automated testing, manual testing, code reviews, static typing, formal verification, you pick your poison. However, if we are trying to implement lean and/or agile, then the way to avoid defects is not by doing a lot of upfront design. Doing heavy amounts of upfront design will rather lead to us producing more waste in these other categories. Number 4, inventory. In manufacturing, this refers to holding too much in inventory. Too many parts, work in progress items, or finished goods. The downside is, of course, that we have increased holding costs. The warehouse has to be bigger. But is that a problem in software? I mean, software is soft. We don't need a warehouse. Well, in software, this takes the shape of a backlog filled with WIP, work in progress items, meaning unfinished or undeployed tasks. A backlog full of work in progress items can lead to complicated merge conflicts in the future because we have too many things going on at the same time. But it can also lead to a situation where our work in progress items become outdated, meaning that the customer demands actually change before we have the time to finish these uncompleted stories. So how do you deal with this in software? Well, we should apply work in progress limits. We should make sure that we complete stories before we open new ones. So if you happen to use Kanban, then we should use it as a pull system rather than as a push system, which is how Kanban was intended to be used. So instead of dividing our teams into, say, testers and developers, and then letting these two groups, these two teams, complete as many stories as they can, we should use cross-functional teams or cross-functional individuals and focus on completing whatever stories we currently have opened before we open new ones. So if one group is moving faster than another group, that doesn't mean that that group should keep pushing out features because we have a bottleneck. The work in progress just grows and grows and grows for this other team. Instead, we should reallocate. We should move some of the people from the team that's moving faster to the other team. So we're not collecting a bunch of work in progress items, and so that we're instead bringing tasks to completion before we open up new tasks. This is related to the very interesting concept called one-piece flow in lean manufacturing. I highly recommend that you check out the books that I've linked in the description. So the problem with siloed teams is that if the teams move at different pace, then we will accumulate work in progress over time. By the way, the diagram known as a cumulative flow diagram is a great diagram if you're looking to find work in progress issues. Number 5, transportation. In manufacturing, this refers to the movement of things. And in software, we can think of this as the movement of code or data between systems or environments. So unnecessarily complicated deployment pipelines, or moving large pieces of data to the algorithm instead of moving the algorithm to the data. There's no one obvious solution here in software because the problems are so many and so different. But generally, the point is to try to optimize, to streamline the transportation of things so that we can focus more of our energy and our resources on activities that produce value for the customer. Do note that this does not mean that we should optimize for speed. The question is whether we can streamline transportation so that we can focus our energy on delivering value to the customer. Sometimes that means our transportation needs to be quick, sometimes not. Number 6. Motion. In manufacturing, this refers to the movement of people. And in software, this can again take many forms. Here are some examples. Excessive context switching, perhaps caused by interruptions or having to work on multiple stories at the same time or having to switch between different projects. As programmers, we are manipulating these intricate and complex structures that we have modeled inside of our heads. So the cost of task switching is of course very real for programmers, because as soon as we switch from one task to another task, we have to rebuild all that complex structure that we had built inside of our heads and potentially then restart from scratch. We have to reboot our mental models every time we switch tasks. What are some other examples? Excessive meetings, manually performing tasks that could be automated, having to deal with poorly organized code or documentation, which means that we're spending a lot of time trying to figure out how we should do something or what we should do instead of just doing the thing, and so forth and so forth and so forth. Number 7. Waiting. This is essentially the problem of bottlenecks. In manufacturing, this includes waiting for people, for materials, for orders, for approvals, for machines, and so forth and so forth. In software, this is quite similar, and it's of course extremely common. We have to wait for dependent user stories to be completed, for access rights to different systems, for approval from stakeholders, for feedback from stakeholders, for feedback from customers, for approval from legal entities or other gatekeepers. But it can also also mean things like waiting for a massive test suite to complete, or for the code to compile, or for getting the environment set up or booted up, or for deployment, and so forth and so forth. If you think about it, we spend a lot of time waiting, not producing value. So the question we should ask ourselves is how we can streamline the process to reduce waiting times so that we can focus our time on producing value for the customer. Number 8. Untapped human potential, also known as unused talent or underutilized skills. This 8th waste was not part of the original list stemming from the Toyota factories. It has been added by the lean community over time. But if you think about it, it's a very important one. It's about failing to tap into the ideas and skills of our employees, failing to ask team members what they think, failing to utilize everyone's skills to the fullest. This, of course, can result in anything from low team motivation and inefficiencies due to mismatched roles to missing huge opportunities. Those were the 8 wastes of lean applied to software development. Let us know in the comments which ones of these you've seen in your professional life. Subscribe.